Greetings. Thank you for lending an ear to The Voice of the Times for Thursday, April 29, 2021. For today's editorial, DTI stands up for vehicle buyers. The Department of Trade and Industry deserves to be complimented for taking decisive action to resolve a persistent consumer issue, one that has troubled buyers of vehicles, in particular motorcycles, for quite some time. The DTI recently issued Department Administrative Order 2103, or Guidelines for Payment Options on the Purchase of Consumer Products and Services, ordering vehicle dealers to stop selling vehicles on an installment-only basis and to conspicuously post a clear explanation of customers' payment options in their premises. DAO 2103 was signed by Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez on March 23 and was to go into effect 2 weeks later, but due to reporting requirements and the interruption of the Easter holiday, was only reported to the public this week. The order also stipulates that the price of items being sold should remain the same regardless of what mode of payment the customer uses, such as various forms of electronic payment, but that sellers can still offer discounts for cash payments. Under the Consumer Act, violators will be imprisoned for a period of 5 months to 1 year or fined 500 to 10,000 pesos or both. The order was made in response to growing complaints from consumers, mostly buyers of motorcycles, that dealers were forcing them to sign up for installment payments even if they were able to pay cash. As of mid-February this year, at which point the issue was raised in a Senate hearing, the DTI reported that it had received more than 3,000 consumer complaints related to motorcycle sales, of which less than 300 had been resolved. Other practices related to installment payments that consumers have complained to the DTI about include being obliged to sign agreements allowing dealers to repossess motorcycles without notice in the case of missed installment payments and withholding the customer's official receipt and certificate of registration until all payments have been completed. According to people familiar with the automotive and motorcycle industries, there is no legitimate reason why a dealer would refuse a cash payment. For dealers who do not necessarily have other nefarious motives, obliging customers to make installment-only purchases allows them to charge a slightly higher price for bikes being purchased, taking advantage of the fact that a monthly installment payment of a few thousand pesos sounds like a small and easy manageable expense to most people. Some dealers also have finder's fee arrangements with preferred loan partners, arrangements that are not legally bound to disclose to customers, in which a small percentage of the loan interest payments are paid back to the dealer in exchange for steering business to the lender. A few dealers take advantage of their customers in even worse ways. Although most dealers do consider customers' creditworthiness properly, there are others that intentionally sell motorcycles to people who would not otherwise qualify for financing. The idea behind this ploy, according to the experts, is that these customers are expected to default on their loans at some point, usually relatively quickly, allowing the dealer to repossess the machine and sell it again. Regardless of whether the dealer's motivations are only slightly improper or more so, imposing a scheme that forces the customer to pay more than the reasonable value for a vehicle is exploitative. It is particularly so during these uncertain times when consumers' financial stability is under seemingly constant threat. To be sure, the DTI's order, apart from directing dealers to make information on payment options even clearer to customers, does not address anything that was not already in the law. Nevertheless, it is encouraging to see the DTI respond in quick fashion to a widespread consumer issue. The drafting and issuing of the administrative order took just a month, which in the context of normal government work is lightning fast. The department deserves credit for a job well done. And that's the editorial for Thursday, April 29, 2021. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to its digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and listen to the Voice of the Times.